Hi folks, and welcome back to Let's Play Eye of the Beholder 2! We're jumping right back in here, and we're gonna get to watch party members get electrocuted again, and... yay. How many tries does it take? Well, that's our first death. That's our second death. Damn it, Rove. The elves are just trading off on who gets to die in the background. Oh. Rove's got 3, 4. There we go. See, I don't think it'll let us sleep here. Yeah. It's not safe to rest there. But we can rest in the other area just fine. I don't know. Okay. Now we have a couple choices as to how we tackle the rest of this. There's like a path that leads, as you can see here, they shift. We could follow that path, and there's stuff over there. Or we could do the same thing and go over here. We're actually gonna cross, because, if I recall correctly, there's like a key or something over there that we need. However, it is made more difficult by the fact that running through this, you always get fried at least once. Right here, yeah. And there's also these jerks here waiting. And that causes you to get fried a second time, and then you're probably dead. And that axe over there, I think, is like cursed or something. Or no, it's, I think, like +2. It's not gonna be worth my time. So I'm gonna try this again. And I just realized I saved over the wrong episode's save slot. Ow. And I just electrocuted myself twice. Kill it. Kill it. Kill it. Nope. And there goes Sanrael. Sunrael, rather. So yeah, this is just frustrating. And there's no way to get around it, I don't think. So you've got to suffer. Oh, or get lucky. Burning hands. Fireball. Rove. Gold leaf. Switch up. Oh, that would have been a dead Rove. Oh, and the paralysis begins. Come on. Okay, we got one more here. Oh, we got lucky. We got lucky. Oh, there goes Calandra. Alright, luck has run out, but we have magic missiles instead. Okay, and now, if I recall correctly, somewhere along here, I think that, does this open it? No, that, yeah, that turns off the path so that we can get through again without having to kill anybody. And we got a bone key. Also a dagger, which may or may not be worth anything. Let's rest here a little bit and let's find out. Detect, no, cure light wounds, rope. Find out whether this dagger is magical or not. Detect magic. No, don't care. Alright. That axe, I can't recall 100% whether or not it's actually worth anything. Alright. Nothing there. Oh, longsword hunger. This thing's cursed, but we need it. What we got here? The plaque reads, "What can be trusted?" Nothing ventured, nothing gained. Okay, so let's venture a potion of vitality. And we got a wand. A wand of... no, not lightning bolt. what is this a wand of? Lightning, okay. I suppose we could take a wand of lightning bolt. Sure, why not? I really need to identify all these wands he has, but I just don't care enough to. I wonder if we... do I have any crappy things I can just throw in there? Yeah, because I value this potion of vitality higher than random dart number 312. Okay, we're gonna sleep, regain our spells, and see what's behind bone key door number 1. Whether or not it will be something interesting, I do not know, but we shall find out after 3 weeks worth of sleeping. So much sleep. Okay. Let's save in the proper slot this time. Okay. And... bone key. Oh, there's a door with a button. That is a thing. And a cocoon with a freaking, ow, mantis in it. This one doesn't have a weapon. It's still paralyzing people though. Wow, there's absolutely nothing in here. I actually think I'm just gonna reload. Because that isn't, I don't know if we can use this bone key elsewhere, I do not recall. But we're gonna find out. We can make a jump for that axe. Why not? The party can survive one zap. Oh, hey, and it turned these off too. That's actually kind of handy. Alright, is it cursed? Yeah, that's what I thought. Alright. Damn it. I want to memorize. I'm just going to have him toting around a remove curse spell. Oh, of course it's not safe to rest here. Is it safe to rest here? No. But it is right here. Why? I don't know. But it is. Come on, guys. Like, seriously. 60 hours. Jeez. Freaking minus two. Yeah, there you go. Well, I got the two right, at least, I guess. Haste. Prayer. We're all doing okay on food. Let's get these guys back to their death magics. And ow! Okay, whoa! Wait, that thing wasn't there just a second ago. I'm not crazy. That thing just, like, popped in. Alright. I doubt this is a magic dagger, but, yeah. Figured I might as well check. Okay, there's a door we can pry. We're not gonna go that way quite yet. Gonna kind of poke around. Alright. Keyhole up. Keyhole, and through here. We do have that key to that. Of the bones, you need three. Together, they are the key. Okay. This is why we brought bones with us. You have made me very happy. Now I reward you with the key. Now, I actually didn't recall that you needed three specifically. That's just how many I happen to have. So, happy accident. And we have another bone key. Oh, hey. Oh my god, the paralysis. I'm gonna be picking up frickin' remove paralysis so soon. Oh, that thing. Oh, hit it anyways. That's all that matters to me. Flicka! The plus five dagger of awesomitude. And her magic arrow. Okay. If I recall correctly, this is bad, yeah. Suddenly, the air is filled with a high-pitched whistle. You turn just in time to see a mantis warrior throw a spear-like object at you. And we go around. That would have been one of those orbs of fireballs, or beads of fireball that we've been finding. That one just happened to have one, and it threw it at me like a big old jerk. So we introduced it to some fire. I'm gonna introduce this one to some ice. It was effective. Okay. Plus five. Alright. Gonna have Goldleaf pray here. Give her one prayer to remove paralysis. I like prayer just for the, you know, to hit bonus it gives us. So that the melees can actually occasionally smack what they're swinging at. But I'm thinking that one is plenty for the time being. Especially when we've got things that are paralyzing us. I'm also gonna save. Yes. Okay. Exit. Alright. Haste. Prayer. Sandroll, look busy. I think this is just a dead end, yeah. Let's see, I think you go boof. No, you have to. Eh. There we go. Hey, look! Another key! Isn't that just darn handy? I'm actually impressed how many of the puzzles in this game I remember. Most of them are, whoa, admittedly fairly simple, but I don't care. Because I'm so derpy that, like, even a simple, hey, I didn't forget how to do, you know, something a four-year-old could is, that's a win in my book. Alright, Dispel Magic and Blur, we're just gonna leave these here. I'd give them to Sunrail. But my problem is that, like, I don't want to spend too much time giving him a bunch of spells because I'm not going to be taking him into the next game with me. So it's really not worth my time to be giving him spells just to have them. Like with Rove, I will. That's why he's got, like, a bunch of spells that I know I'm never going to use because, you know, he's at least going to be there through till the end. Sunrail, on the other hand, has no such luxury. I'm not gonna remove paralysis quite yet. Now, the reason we're hacking all of these things open is because at the end of the room, there's those. You can just grab them now, but if you do that, all of these things hatch, and you've got to fight 8 Mantis Men or 10 Mantis Men, however many it is, all at once. And no, that will not end well for us. Swell can barely take it as it is. Murph. Oh. Oh. Okay, screw it. Remove paralysis. Let's get Swell back into the fight here. Eh, and she is immediately paralyzed. And there goes Sunrail. Come around that corner. Seriously? You cheeky sucker. Got burning hands for you. Things are fast, too. Which makes it somewhat more challenging. I can't dance around them. Ow, quite as well because they attack immediately after moving. Okay. This is a puzzle, actually. You pick up this gem and you're like, I wonder what I'm going to do with this. So you just kind of stow it on your person and go about your questing. And then you get stuck about 20 minutes later. And you're like, well, what the hell am I supposed to do with this gem? All you're supposed to do is just stick it back in after you take it. I don't know. I don't know how you're supposed to figure that out. But when you do, you get more orbs of fireballs. You get a mantis idol, which we need later, and a copper key. So yeah, I don't know. Not questioning it. Okay, and with the copper key, we are now ready to go on up. Oh, seriously? You friggin' jerks. Where'd they come from? I don't know. No more fireball, no more fireball. Lightning bolts work, though. Alright, and we're gonna sleep at the base of these stairs here. High adventure in the Temple Dark Moon. High adventure. Okay. So I'm gonna save again. Because cowardice. And we are going to head on out. If I recall correctly, there's something on the next level that's kind of obnoxious. I think it's like bees. Like I'm 90% sure. Yeah, it's freaking bees. They have the most annoying attack sound in the entire game. They are, however, quite susceptible to the lightning bolts. And they poison us, which I should have probably prepared for before I came up. Oh, not only do they poison us, they paralyze too, apparently. That's great. Let's see here. Oh, yeah, and they got nests too, which I don't think you can do anything with. Oh, dang it. That was amongst the list of things Gina's done that weren't particularly intelligent. Give that one a lightning ball, give that one a fireball. I really don't recall what is back here that we need, but I know that there's something back here that we need, if that makes sense. Come on. Okay. A femur, we've already got the bones. Cure poison potion. Actually, I'm gonna take this. I don't recall if we need more. And I'm stupid enough that we very well, oh my god. We may well need more of them, and I've just misremembered. Alright, we're gonna remove paralysis here. Get some serious melee power going on. Some magic missiles from Rove. Cure Sirius. Wow, that was effective. Friggin' 6 hit points. There's the poison. Okay. Okay. Oh my god. How come I'm not out of here? Oh, there's Swell. Oh, only poison. I am okay with this. Okay. Hey, look, there appears to be movement up in the wasp nest. Okay, so we done going in a circle. Gonna pull back. Okay, entry, and we're going down the stairs. Potion of cure poison. Potion of cure poison. Sleepy time. That wouldn't have been quite so close if I hadn't run into that fireball and dealt like 20 points of damage to my entire party. But I am not a smart man. It's actually fairly low damage for that fireball, because back in second edition they did like 1-6 per caster level. And Rove's what, 9th? Yeah, so 96. I don't know, that's like 32 average damage. So yeah, he rolled low. Of course they probably changed it in this, it wouldn't surprise me. Oh god. Faith is the key. Yeah, this is gonna make me rage. I hate this. I don't remember. You're supposed to hit these buttons in a particular order. Is it this one? Nope, I just boned myself. Because one of the pits is like a fake. So I'm gonna go this one. This one. This one. No. Okay, then it's this one last, so... This one, no. Oh, Lord. This one. This one. This one. No. That one. Darn it. So maybe it's this one that's the fake. So... Oh, darn it. Let me go this one. This one. This one. And this one. No. Reloading. Load. Yes. Wait a minute. I think I might have... borked up. Hold on. This one. This one. This one. And it's there. Alright, yeah. If I recall correctly, there's a button down this hallway you have to press. Let's use this too. Alright. Okay, now I need a third one. I assume then that this is the last one as opposed to the one I actually need it to open. Yeah. Okay, so I need to go this one, that one, and that one, which means this one, and this one. Okay. Ah, lower bricks on the west wall. That. And now you come in and hit that one. Ha! Okay, yeah. I hated that puzzle. That is something that, as a kid, I never could figure it out. Wow, that was over quick. Alright. Let's solve our little bee problem. I also forgot to memorize cure poison, because I'm an idiot. Sigh. More paralysis. Yay. I completely forgot that these things paralyzed you. Completely forgot. Hey, we got a key for this. In we go. Greetings once again! You have almost completed the test of faith. There is one more obstacle which you must face. You have learned well, and I trust that our teachings have not been in vain. The door to the left will lead you to the next trial. The door to the right is almost certain death. Now, I don't remember whether or not he's BSing you. So I'm gonna actually save in a side slot here. We're gonna take the door to the right, because badassery abounds. Oh, there we go. Stairs up. Is this certain death? I don't know. I thought I heard someone whistling in the distance. Oh, really? A plaque reads, the way through three is 2, not 4. Okay, what do we got down here? A bone door. Oh, we have a key. Poison, of course, is up. We got... whatever the heck those things are supposed to be. Maybe just normal flying snakes. What a ring. Is it a magic ring? Yes, 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 yes! Alright. Ring of Adornment. Bulk! God damn it, trolling game. Alright. Remove paralysis. Neutralize poison. Raise dead. Healing. Oh. see here. Can they survive? Poison party members already died, rest anyways. Yes. No, healers will not heal the party. Okay, yeah. So they're not gonna survive long enough. That was why I saved in a different slot. Okay. Let's do that. Do that. Do that. Come down here. Hit that. Come back here. Hit that. Alright. Pray. Switch over to neutralize poison. Sleep. Okay. Save because I'm a coward. And haste. Also prayer. And ready the burning hand. No, actually, ready the lightning bolts. Alright, you stupid jerk bees. I'm ready for you now. Screw you and your obnoxious ting sound. Okay. Ah. Okay, yeah, we know. Yeah, yeah, yeah. Okay. We're gonna save. We're gonna go through the left door and see if he's lying. I think he is. Yeah, it just teleports us back to the start. Okay. And beat the crap out of Swell for some reason. Dick game lion. Alright. I thought I heard someone whistling in the distance. I legit don't remember what that is. Okay, there's the bone door. Alright. Last thing, the last children of Darkmoon did not heed our warnings. Now they're the dust which we blow down these corridors. Will you become dust as well? Skulls. If I recall correctly, some of these magic mouths will, like, spit fireballs at you. I remember some of them are kind of jerks. Alright. 3 is 2, not 4. 1, 3, 3. The way through is 2. Well, there's no 4, though. The way through 3 is 2, not 4. I don't remember what's on the side of these, so we're just gonna go through all of them. Oh, that's a fireball trap. Okay. That is not a beholder, actually. That is a gas spore. You see how it doesn't have, like, a mouth and its eyes aren't really eyes, they're just little poofs? I think it'll attack us. But the thing is, you're like, oh, it's a beholder, let's melee it. You don't want to do that, because when you shoot them, they explode. Like that. So, yeah. Dick. That is one of D&D's big troll monsters. When we have feasted, it is I who sings the praise. When we have hungered, it is I who breathes the pain. Yeah, he spits fireballs, if I recall correctly. So I'm not gonna just sit there and stand in front of him. Anything on the walls? No. Nah. Okay. Rotten food? Yes. Okay, we actually need these. Okay. Oh, just snakes. Flying snakes. And this level is actually really easy to get lost on, so expect that to happen. For those of you who actually know how to navigate this game, I'm probably gonna get lost. Because there's a lot of random, like, side passages here. See any buttons? No. Okay. No. Huh? Okay, I guess I killed it. It just didn't play the animation because it was off screen. That's kind of handy to know. Screw you. Okay. What do we got here? Potion of Cure Poison. Potion of Cure Poison. Scroll of Raise Dead. Okay, let's start. Okay, cure poison, cure poison, cure poison. Alright. Healing. Let's give her all of these. Calandra, you can tote potions. There. Okay, anything else? No buttons. That's why you look. Okay. do we got here? Boots magical, possibly, but probably not. Give them to Ash. Some magic bandit armor, a magic short sword. Ooh, and a polearm leech. I wonder how many of these things are cursed. Well, that's not. That is. What a twist. Okay, so let's ID that. Let's ID this. And improved identify. Plus two, plus three. Nice. Alright, so Calandra gets Sting. The short sword actually goes to Ash, so she can two up and fight. And plus two banded mail is not as good as Swell's plus three. Is it better than Gold Leaf's plus two plate? No, her non-magical plate, I should say. Alright. Well, the front line's toting some pretty... Sunrail just leveled. Let's see what new spell death he can throw. Oh, Cone of Cold. Wall of Force, completely useless. However, in the next game, I will use it once, just so you guys can hear the sound effect it makes, because it's the most hilarious thing in the world. And this, I think it just goes like, and that's it. In the second game, it's like, it is the sound I attribute to any great failure in my life, and I think it is quite fitting. And Cone of Cold is an awesome spell. It actually attacks, like, every creature you can see in your screen. Oh! Welcome, children. You have done well thus far. However, your temperament has yet to be challenged. Take heed as you travel forth. Okay. You must not tarry. Consider all that you have learned and choose the right door. Choose wrongly and feel my master's wrath. Alright. So she said, you know, choose the right door. Yeah. Yeah. I think we want to go in the right door. I think. Master's wrath. Unseen voice whispers, very good, very wise. You will make a fine addition to the second order. May you have continued success. Yeah. Yeah, that's kind of dumb. And as you can see, now we can't go back there, and that other area walled itself off. I think if you go back into the other one, you just, like, get trapped there and can't leave or something. Freaking flying snakes are just everywhere. You're, like, flying deadly lice. Or something. I don't know. Ow! You dick mouth. Okay. See, now they gave us that key for this door, but remember we have an extra one because we didn't use it down in the lower levels because there was a room that had nothing in it, and why would we use it to get, you know, attacked by an incubating mantis man? That's just silly. So yeah, we could have skipped all of that if we wanted to, I guess. But yeah, we got some goodies out of it. We got a plus three short sword and some neutralized poison pots, so I'm not complaining. Further in we go. Haste. Prayer. Ready with the burning hands. Shoo. You too. Is that another crap ring? I'm gonna guess it is. Yep. Not even surprised. Okay, we got a key with a dark moon lock on it. Got a passage here that... Please, whoever you are, turn back. It's a trap. Don't come any closer. Okay, this dude, this person, not kidding. I'll show you guys anyways. Okay, it's okay. I warned you not to come here. I have been left to die. You will join me if you do not leave. What do you mean? Like you, I took the test of the cloth, but I failed in my attempt to achieve. We know the cost of failure, and now I must pay the price. I wait for the serpents to come so that I may die with honor. Now leave me before my accursed luck befalls you as well. Now we can kill him or we can leave. I think if we leave, it lets us go, but we're gonna kill him. So, yeah, you heard the door shut. Yeah. And it sounds like the trigger broke beneath us. This is not good. So we're trapped here. This is actually some really good gear and a bunch of, you know, glass spheres of fireballs. But as far as I know, there is absolutely no way to get out of here. So you are trapped, and that is not good. And it is looking like we are at pretty much half an hour. So I think I'm going to call it here. I'm not going to save, so we're good. All right, so as per usual, folks, thank you for watching, and I will see you all next time when our adventures through Dark Moon continue. Until then.